Overcoming obstacles and taking advantage of opportunities has been a way of life for me. As a child, I had to overcome the violent streets of Watts and my family's poverty, as well as the common stereotypes associated with the residents of my own neighborhood. I had to overcome being raised by a single mother who was a crack addict, who had five children with five different men. I had to overcome the senseless murder of my best friend, my uncle, and other friends throughout my neighborhood. Watts is known as one of the worst places to live in America. It is plagued with drugs, gangs, and an overwhelming amount of senseless violence. One constantly hears that people who reside in Watts are listless, corrupt, and violent. One hears that they do not have any sense of morality or family values. One hears that the male youth are not likely to make it past the 10th grade or to their 18th birthday. One hears that the children of Watts will produce too many babies and that the fathers will go to jail while the mothers go on welfare. Most people who speak of Watts have never been to Watts. I say it is a community that has been neglected for too many years, inhabited by some remarkable people who will succeed if given a chance. I was in the 4th grade when my life as I had known it changed forever. I was blessed to meet a very inspirational individual, Tay Collins. Tay was new in town, and she had heard about the ongoing problems that plagued inner city youth, and she wanted to offer assistance. Tay volunteered her time and resources. On weekends, she would take us out to expose us to places outside of Watts. In addition to giving us her own time, Tay surrounded us with other people who acted as positive influences in our lives and let us know that they cared about our futures and wanted to make a substantial difference. There were a couple of things that remained consistent across the board for Tay and her friends. They were all successful in life, and they were all laborious in achieving their success. Tay believed in me, and that gave me the confidence to believe in myself.
I went on a boat for like the first time, and like I went to the beach for the first time too. And like I really had a fun time. And then that year, I think I was a camper of the year that year, so I got to come back the next year too. And then like ever since then, like she just been with us. Like she was just there, like for everything we needed.
She was there for the kids when they needed clothes for school. Christmas. We didn't even have mattress for to sleep on. Tay came with a truck and I said she couldn't be for real because, you know, I never met no one, you know, no one like that. It was always, you know, I was always told you never meet, there's not nice people because you don't get nothing for nothing. But Tay was always there.
Before Tay took me, I didn't even know what the John R. Wooden Award was. One year I wore just a regular tux, but then the next year I wore a white jacket and black pants and everything. I was looking real good that day. I never did nothing like that. Like I had to get fitted for like to try on clothes and nothing like that. And it was like, I don't think I never experienced nothing like that.
Tay is like the nicest person in the world. She is incredible. I haven't seen nobody do nothing like that in like ever. We treat her just like family, like she treat us like family. So
to me, to Tay, she's really nice to us, and she does fun things with us, and we should thank her. I love her so much and all my heart.
She gave my girls the ability to stand alone without having to depend on someone. Being the same mom, she has changed my life. She's helped my son. She can gang bang me. And she touched my son's life to where that he looked up to her like a mom. And she saw that interest in him wanting to learn. And that's what really, really, really put the love there. Because she really wanted to see my son succeed. And she made everything possible. She made him see that education was not afraid, something you'd be afraid of, that you'd be proud of. And when graduation time came, that was the most precious day of his life. I told you one day, if I could take my heart out of my body and live and let you live, I would give it to you. That's the love we have, transplants anything. I would give it the heart out of my body because she deserved everything. I couldn't have met a better friend.
I think this thing I can say I'm most proud of is being staying out of trouble and not going to jail.
Yeah, that's what I'm most proud of right now. Staying out of trouble, going to work every day. Graduating from high school with a 3.5 GPA.
Tay, you know that I love you a lot, and like You're just one of a kind person. You're just the type of person that everybody that I know that loves a lot. You're just that special person, and I love you a lot for that.
Hey. Tay is so nice. Lost you or something special.
I will climb the highest mountain just for you. Bring gold and silver to your door just for you. I will raise my glass up to the sky just for you. I will be your strength and be your bride, be with you. I'll make sweet soul music all night long just for you. Make you feel that you belong just for you. We'll take a ride in the tunnel of love just us two. I will scream aloud at the altar of God, I love you. All this to you, dedicate myself to you, just for you.